is done. Okay, transportation or circulating is complex. And transportation, if you have seen in the plans, so see two types now. If you consider the short plants, which is known as the herbs, so here transportation is not sophisticated. It is you know, not so complicated. But if you by the diffusion, you know, this process can be fulfilled. The transportation of the molecules can be done by the diffusion process in the herb, very short plants. If you are considering the long trees, okay, big trees, then diffusion is not enough. So here, vascular system, mainly the xylem and phloem, are responsible for the conduction of water and food. Okay, so just I'm revising. So yesterday, you know, we have seen, we have discussed about the vascular system. So xylem, which is mainly responsible for the conduction of water and minerals. So the root hairs, you know, just absorb the water and mineral salts from the soil by the osmosis process, and then carried upward, that is unidirectional. Okay, so, and if you see here, by the diffusion, you know, energy is not needed. So we can call it as a passive transport. And if you consider about the phloem, which is mainly responsible for the transportation of the food, okay, and amino acids and so many things. So here, they are bi-directional phloem. See, phloem, the food is transport to upper part as well as the lower part, okay. So we call it as a bi-directional. And we have seen transpiration, okay, transpiration, nothing but the evaporation of the, you know, water, excess of water through the aerial parts, that is the parts which are exposed to the air. So even the stomata, here also transpiration will take place. And translocation, the difference between transpiration and translocation here is, translocation is nothing but the conduction of food by the phloem, okay. So this we have discussed. So I hope all of you have understood this. So today's topic is about the pulse rate. Okay, we'll see, and we'll see about the blood pressure. So after this, you know, the complete lesson, completion of the lesson is done. So shall we start today's topic? Yes, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine, children. So let me just share the screen. Okay, so I will tell you what you mean by pulse, okay? So children, see, all of you can see, you know, pulse. You can feel if you keep the fingers on the wrist area. Now, just all of you can see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, children. Now see, this is okay, the definition here, pulse, okay, I'm just reading. See, we know that the heart pumps the blood in the arteries. This continuous pumping of the blood in the arteries results in their rhythmic thrombing, which is called pulse. So what do you mean by pulse? Pulse is nothing but the, you know, transportation of the blood, okay, by the heart to the arteries. So here we have seen the oxygenated blood is transported by aorta, the biggest artery. Then aorta will be branching into the arterioles, okay. So here arteries, you know, they are all over the body present. So here the arteries which carries oxygenated blood. Then when, see, in the arteries, when the heart pumped the blood, then pressure will be there. Okay, as you compare with the veins, the there is a low pressure, but in the arteries there will be always high pressure. Okay, so because of this pumping, you know, the blood in the arteries, the flow of this, it will make a rhythmic, like, you know, something you can feel by holding your wrist. Okay, so here you can see the diagram. See this area. Okay, so if you see and keep your fingers there, okay, in the index finger and middle finger, you can keep over the wrist part. Okay, here, this area, this, not in the middle, remember here, children, here, when you keep this, you can feel something, you know, lub, like, not sound, I'm telling, we cannot listen the sound, but you can feel, you know, that movement of the blood, thrombing, that is a rhythmic thrombing. Okay, so that is known as the pulse. I hope everybody understood. Okay, got it? Everybody understood? Just keep your finger there. Just, you can see this picture, you see it, and you can keep your finger there. Okay, you just keep your index finger and middle finger, then just try to concentrate. Then you can feel the artery, you know, the movement of the blood, dug, like that. So that is nothing but the rhythmic thrombing. So we call it as the pulse. Okay. Now, what do you mean by the pulse rate? Next, we'll go with the pulse rate. See, pulse rate is defined as the number of pulse beats per minute. So children, see, you know, wait. Okay, now see, your children, if you keep your fingers like this, you know, index finger and the middle finger, this finger and this finger, okay, just keep it here, this area, this part, not middle here. Not here, you should not keep here, okay? So here, if you keep it, you can feel the pulse, like, you know, movement, like rhythmic thrombing, like this, you can feel it like this, because the pressure will be there. That is the artery, okay? Here you can find, the arteries won't be at the superior, you know, towards the skin, it won't be. The arteries will be inside, not to the superior part, okay? Not like this, it will be inside. So here you can feel the rhythmic of thrombing of the pulse. Okay. Now see, children, pulse rate is nothing but the pulse beat, number of pulse beat per minute. If you see, if you keep the watch, okay, 1 minute, if you just start the watch, okay, if it starts with the 12, okay, then it ends, it has to end with the 12, then we call it as the 1 minute, that is the 60 seconds, which will make 1 minute. What you have to do is, you have to just hold here, okay? Just, you have to hold this. When you feel the pulse, then see the watch and start counting, okay? You just start counting. So number of beats per minute, the normal number of beats per minute is 70 to 80, okay? So if the person is having the pulse rate about 70 to 80, or you can also consider as the 85, like that, so it is normal. But for 1 minute, if the person is having more pulse rate, like 90, 100, then definitely there might be any problem. Or if you have done exercise, like, you know, just completed the vigorous exercise, definitely this pulse rate will be, this will increase, okay? This will increase. So just calm down, relax, and then take the watch, you feel the pulse and count it, okay? You can do yourself. So the normal pulse rate count is about 70 to 80 beats per minute. So this is called the pulse rate. I hope everybody have understood about the pulse rate and pulse. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So next part we'll go with the blood pressure, okay? So just a minute. Anything else? So here also see, children. Now this here you can find the artery, you can feel the pulse. Now if you see here, okay, so it's also not in the middle. Just understand, right hand you take it, okay, then don't keep it in the middle, just side by that, okay, side by that you can feel the pulse where you find, like, you know, lapped up sound varthadala hangala sound illa, but the movement you can feel. Then there also you can just keep your fingers and count your pulse rate, then you will get there. See, most of the doctors, they keep the stethoscope there, you know. The stethoscope is the instrument to measure the pulse rate, okay? So this is okay. Then all of you know that for pulmonary artery. Yes, who can tell me the pulmonary artery? What you have understood about the pulmonary artery? Can anybody tell me? See, this is the stethoscope, okay? So this stethoscope is used to measure the pulse rate. Even we can listen the heartbeat by this stethoscope. You can see, you know, listen, dub, dub, lub, dub, lub, dub, sound barthati. If you keep it towards the chest area where the heart is located, okay? So see, the name of this is stethoscope, okay? So yes, I think you have all understood about this. You got it? Yes, children, have you all understood about this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now see, we'll go with the blood pressure, okay? What do you mean by the blood pressure? Blood pressure is taken using two measurements, that is systolic. See, always remember, the blood pressure is divided into two. See, the heartbeat, you know, the normal BP, blood pressure is 120 by 80 mm of Hg, that is millimeter per mercury. Okay, so remember this, the normal you know, range of the blood pressure, BP, is the healthy person, the normal healthy person blood pressure is about 120 by 80 mm Hg. Okay, now here 120 by 80, these are the two things, two measured, that is systolic and diastolic. Remember this, the two you know, blood pressure, systolic and diastolic. I'll tell you what do you mean by the systolic and diastolic. Now see, the blood pressure is taken using two measurements, that is systolic, which is measured, that is when the heart beats, when blood pressure is at the highest. So when the blood pressure in the arteries is at the highest point, that we call it as the systolic. When the blood pressure is at the lowest point, we call it as the diastolic. Okay, so see, children, just a minute, I'll come back to you. Now see here, so here, see, have you observed, you know, the doctor, you know, they will keep this sphygmomanometer, we call it as that instrument, okay? So here they will just you know, apply that, they'll put the cups, okay? What they will do, that rubber, you know, this will be there, like instrument, they will just press it. Why? They are just blowing the air, okay? So that cups, you know, it will just increase. When it increase, what will happen? the arteries, you know, the pressure on the arteries will be created. More arteries, see, upper pressure, it's not inner pressure, okay, children. So upper pressure when we are applying, then there is a blockage, I mean the stop of the flow of blood, okay. So at that time, you know, what happens? We don't listen the rhythmic sound, lub-dub. That is the highest pressure, okay. We are creating the highest pressure. So what we do, the doctor, you know, what he does, so slowly he will just loosen the, you know, screw so that air will pass. So when the air starts decreasing in the cups, you know, so what will happen to the one point? Okay, see, just a minute, I'll show you the picture of that, okay? Okay, now see children, yeah, Now, see the children, see this picture. All of you just open the page number 73. All of you can see that picture? Yes, children, all of you can see that picture. See page number 73. All of you open that? All of you have opened?
Yes, ma'am.
Ah, yes. So see there carefully. See, it's given about the blood pressure, you know. What is the blood pressure? Okay, the force which is exerted, okay, on the blood. See, the force that blood exerts against the wall of a vessel. So, the pressure which is exerted on the vessels, okay, so that is known as the blood pressure. So, blood pressure is exerting the force. To whom it is exerting? It is exerting to the vessels. Okay, so this is known as the blood pressure. Okay, now see, this pressure is much greater in the arteries. What I told you, always remember this. See, the blood, oxygenated blood, which is flowing from the heart to the aorta and from there to the arteries will carry more pressure. So when it reaches the capillaries, you know, the pressure will be lowered. And then the capillaries again are connected to the veins. I told you, you know, last classes we have discussed. So the veins do not contain more pressure. So we can say that arteries have high pressure and the veins have low pressure. Okay. So the pressure of blood inside the artery during ventricular systole. See, that is ventricles when contract. Okay. So ventricular, you can say like this also. What I told you, the arteries which are having high pressure, that is known as systolic. Or you can say that the ventricles when they contract, or ventricular systole, when they contract, that is known as the systolic pressure. And when they relax, that is known as the diastolic pressure. Okay. So just I'm reading, listen again carefully. The pressure of blood inside the artery during ventricular systole, that is contraction, is called systolic pressure. So whenever the ventricular pressure that is contracted in the artery, that is known as the systolic pressure. And the pressure in the artery during ventricular diastole, that is the relaxation period, that pressure is known as the diastolic pressure. Nothing but arteries when they have high pressure, so they will contract, that is systolic pressure. And arteries which relaxes, that is known as low pressure, which is having low pressure, then they are known as the diastolic pressure. So we write as the systolic 120 by systolic and diastolic pressure. They are the both different, but together what we say, okay. So 120 by 80 mmHg. This is the normal blood pressure of a healthy adult person. Okay. So here, this pressure, both it is systolic and diastolic. Got it? Systolic and diastolic. Got it? Everybody understood? Yes, children?
Yes.
Okay. Now see here. I'll write it here. Okay. Systolic pressure. Then diastolic pressure. So here remember, systolic arteries which have high pressure or ventricular systole, that is nothing but the contraction. And here diastolic, lower pressure, relaxation of the arteries. Or you can say that ventricular diastole, that is relaxation, same it is, don't get confused. Okay. So this is the systolic and diastolic pressure. Together we call it as the 120 by 80 mmHg, the normal blood pressure of a healthy adult person. Okay, just remember. Now see, you can see here, the picture if you observe, see, there is an artery which has the blood. Okay, here the artery is full of blood which is transported. See, it is circulated. You see, just see that. Blood pressure 120 by 80. Okay, 120 systolic and 80 diastolic. Now, this is done. Now, see what they have used here. They have used the instrument here. See this. They didn't use the stethoscope yet. Stethoscope is used in next one. So, this one, this is filled with air. How it is? This is pumped, okay? This, all of you can just visit the hospital and just you can see there, okay? So what they are doing, they are applying the pressure, that is they are increasing the air. When the air is increased inside that cups, what will happen? It will just block the artery, the flow of blood. See, here in this picture you can see. Now here this artery is having blood. Now this pressure is exerted on this. Here, can you observe the blood here? Can you see this blood? Yes? Can you see the blood in that artery?
No, ma'am.
No. Because here the pressure is exerted on the artery. So blood is not flowing in this. So see there what it is written. Blood pressure in cuff above 120. See, now this is increased to the cuff to 140 or to 160. So what will happen when this increases? This increases, the flow of blood is stopped. Okay, when this is increased. So the flow of blood to the arteries, that is downward, is stopped because of this cuff, which is having more, exerting more pressure on the artery. Then slowly, if we release the screw, leak the air. Slowly, if you leak the air till 120, how much not we have, we should not see 120. What we have to see, what we have to feel the rhythmic sound, lab dab. Then that is known as the systolic pressure. Whatever the person is having, for example, if the person is heard to 130, okay, 130 mmHg, this systolic. then what we say that the person is having high systolic pressure. Okay, so it is high. If the person, the sound, the lap duct sound is heard up to 130, okay, we listen and just, okay, lap duct sound is heard, then where it is? It is 130. So then we can say that systolic pressure is high. If the lap duct sound is heard on 120, then we say systolic is 120, that is normal. Then what again? See, again now here. If you see with the next picture here, see. Now slowly they are releasing the air. Now the blood is flowing. It starts flowing. Then with the help of stethoscope, the sound is heard. Wherever the first sound is heard, that we call it as the systolic pressure. Got it? Now diastolic pressure, how we have to do? Diastolic pressure, okay. So next picture, if you again see, now see the third picture, okay. Pressure in cuff below 120 degrees. So what we are doing now, we are again reducing, we are decreasing the air. So it is going to 120, again we are leaving the air, it comes to 100. Again, it is coming like, see, it continuously when it is coming down to some extent, you know, again the sound is not heard. Here, when we come below this, the sound is not heard. Okay. When it reaches to 80 or whatever, like, you know, if the sound is heard, see that. See, you can see this here. Just read this. Sound is audible. Sounds audible in stethoscope. We can listen the sound. But now see, when we are decreasing the, again, you know, decreasing the air, I mean, just leaving out the air. So see, at 80, it is reached. So here at 80, it is reached. Then what happens? Sound stop. Okay. Now, for example, we are decreasing. Now the sound stops. We are listening. 120, we are getting the sound. Okay. 100 also, we heard the sound. Okay. But what happened? To the 90, we didn't hear the sound. That means the diastolic pressure is 90. Again, it is not good. If the pressure is about 130 to 90, then what we say, we can say that it is high pressure. If it exceeds, you know, for example, if it goes with 100 by 50, then it is hypo, means it is less pressure, low BP. This we call it as the high BP, and here we call it as the low BP. Why? Here at 100, we listen the sound, but at 50, we didn't listen the sound. So we write here 100 by 50. This is systolic and diastolic. Then at this blood pressure, we can say that whether it is a high BP or it is a low BP. Got it? Everybody understood? Yes, all of you have understood this? Yes,
yes, children? Ma'am.
All of you understood? See, listen, children. When we are increasing the air, so by this cuff, The pressure is exerted on the artery. The flow of blood will stop. Okay. Slowly we are releasing out the air. So what is happening? We are trying to listen the sound laughter. At whatever, you know, the first sound of the left dub is heard, that is systolic pressure. And again, we are decreasing the pressure because we want the diastolic pressure also to be known. So we are decreasing. Now sound is heard, lab dub, lab dub, lab dub, lab dub. But to one point, you know, the sound do not, it is heard, okay? We don't hear it. So when it is not heard, we take it as the diastolic pressure. So then we can write it whatever the sound we have heard, that one systolic, and wherever we didn't listen the sound, the first sound which is not heard, then we can write that diastolic. Then overall we can say what is the BP of a person, whether it is hyper or it is hypo, or high BP and low BP. Got it? Everybody understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so here we complete the lesson, okay, life processes. So I'll give you the fill in the blanks, okay? Everybody just write down the fill in the blanks. As many possible, I will write on the board, and remaining I'll just WhatsApp it, okay? Fine, everybody understood?
Ma'am, send the whole fill in the blanks in the WhatsApp only.
So you don't want me to write on the board? Let me send you the PDF itself, complete PDF of question answers. Okay, just check it out. I'll send you the PDF right now and tell me, okay, where it is. And just wait a minute, I'll send. All of you can see me, or you cannot see the screen? All of you can see me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, just a minute. Yes. So yes, just check. Wait. All of you got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Just open it. Everybody open it. Children, everybody just open. Hey, who's making that sound? Thank you.
cracking sound. I don't understand what's happening. Children, can you listen to me? I don't know what's the problem. Yes. All of you, open it.
Open it. Open it.
Children, you don't want me to take the class. You want to just leave the class. I mean, you're not interested in science class. Because, you know, daily, these problems are arising. I don't know what about the other classes. But in my class, I think it's daily. Yes. Yes, children.
Yes, children.
Okay, all of you have got PDF. Did you open that? Did you open all of you? Yes, what is the first question? Who can tell me? Aditya.
What are life process?
Yes. What are life process? So, how many questions did you find there?
Ma'am, 39.
Just mute. First thing is mute. Why the sound is mute? Oh shit. Yes. So, tomorrow you'll write the test. Okay. Of this lesson, life processes.
This lesson, life processes.
I'll leave the class. Fine, bye.